Hello guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to use the cloth filter tool in Blender, and also at the end of this video I will show you how I created this cool furniture within cloth filter. So let's get started. Okay, so here's our empty scene. So let's add in a mesh and a plane, and now I will show you how to use the cloth filter. So let's scale this one up just a little bit and let's apply the scale. So press Ctrl A and select scale to apply the scale. Now let's go to edit mode and let's add some geometry to this plane. So let's go to edit mode and let's select this face and let's subdivide, and we will subdivide it 25 times. Okay, so now let's go to object mode again and let's add in a subdivision surface modifier for more geometry, and we'll set the level viewport to 2 and render to 2 also. Now let's go to edit mode again, and now we have to select some geometry which we will simulate with our cloth filter. So let's select this edge and hold alt and click to select the whole edge loop, and let's press Ctrl B to bevel, and let's bevel it just a little bit. Okay, so let's set the segments to 2 so that we have one segment in between. Now let's go to sculpting mode, and now let's go all the way down till you see this cloth in a box. Okay, so this is cloth filter, so let's select that. And now we need face sets to work with, so if you go to edit mode, and also face sets mean that the faces you have selected. So let's go to faces, and now as you can see these faces are selected in edit mode. Now let's go to sculpting mode, and now if you go to face sets and if you select face sets from edit mode selection, you will see that a blue line has appeared which is our face set. And face sets works in a similar way as mask, but I will show you how to use that. So currently the filter type is gravity. So what will gravity do is that it will simulate gravity on the specific part of our object. So if we check this, use face sets, and now if you hover the mouse over our face sets and if you drag it on the right, you will see that only these face sets is simulating gravity. In the similar way, if you undo that and hover the mouse anywhere on our object, and if you right drag, you will see that the face set is not simulating gravity but the whole object. So if we left drag this, you will see that it is doing the vice versa which we have done before. So this is just gravity, and I don't use gravity that much, but inflate is very interesting one. So if we select inflate and let's apply this subdivision surface modifier, and let's add in another subdivision surface modifier for even more geometry. Now let's hover the mouse on our face set and let's drag it to the left. Now this might slow down your computer, but it's worth trying it. So let's drag again, and you will see that we have done the opposite of inflate, which means that we have deflated on our face set. Now if we just inflate our, if we want to just inflate our polygons, so let's hover the mouse anywhere except our face set and let's drag it to the right, and you will see that it is inflating. So if you turn off overlays, you will see that we have created this sieving or upholstery pattern which we can't do in our object mode or with cloth simulation. So it is very useful for that. Now let's undo that. Now let's see how to use expand. And what expand does is that it expands a certain polygon just like scale, but it is not scaling, it is just making the polygons even bigger. So if I drag, if you drag this face set over to the right, you will see that it is making the polygon bigger, and it is very helpful in specific conditions. So let's expand this. Now you can see that it is just scaling the polygons. Now let's see pinch. Now pinch works in specific areas. Now if we pinch over this area, you will see that where we have started dragging our mouse, it is working only in that area, not on the whole object. Pinch does not work on the whole object, it just works on a specific area. Now let's use another object for our demonstration. So let's add in a cylinder, and let's go to edit mode. So hold alt and select this edge loops, I mean face loop, and let's press Ctrl B to bevel, and let's bevel something like that, and also make sure that we have a segment in between our bevel. Now let's go to sculpting mode and also make sure to apply the scale. So press Ctrl A and apply the scale, and let's go to sculpting mode. Now let's select again facets from edit mode selection. Now if you want to shrink the selection, press Ctrl Alt and W, but we have minimum of that selection, that's why it has erased the whole selection. And if you want to increase the selection, press Ctrl W to increase the selection. So let's undo that and let's select our cloth filter which is already selected. Now let's go to scale and make sure that use facets is selected. Now hover the mouse over our facets and drag it to the left. Now you will see that it is scaling down, but we have to add in subdivision surface modifier. So let's set that to 2, apply, and let's again add it, and let's set that to 2, and hover the mouse over the facets and press Ctrl Alt W to decrease the selection as I have said. Okay, I think this is fine. So now let's drag the cursor over to the left. Now you can see that we are scaling down the polygons of the facets, and now you can see that it has created very cool furniture shape that even I don't have expected. Now let's hover our mouse anywhere on our polygons and let's drag it to the right. Now you can see that it has scaled the polygons which were the white one, and now you can see that it has created some cool patterns. Now let's see inflate, which is the most I use. So let's hover the cursor over facets and let's drag it to the left to deflate. And now let's hover the cursor over the polygons and let's drag it to the right. Now let's drag it again to the left. And let's again drag to the right. Now as you can see, we have created a cool luxury chair for sitting in front of a mirror. And now let me show you how I created this furniture in the thumbnail. So let's add in a cylinder and go to fronting mode, and let's scale it down just a little bit and scale on the z-axis, and let's move it upwards and scale down on the z-axis just a little bit. Okay, now press Ctrl A to apply the scale. Now let's go to edit mode and let's select this whole face loop, but first let's add in an edge loop in the middle and let's rotate it on the z-axis just like that. So just a little bit. Okay, now select all of these faces. So hold Alt and click to select the whole face loop and press Ctrl B to bevel. Okay, and now let's go to modifier and add in a subdivision surface modifier. Set the levels to 2 and hit apply. Now let's again add in a subdivision surface modifier and set that to 2. Now let's go to sculpting mode and select facets from edit mode selection and hover the mouse over the facets and press Ctrl Alt W to shrink the selection. Okay, just like that. And let's go to our cloth filter, already selected. Now let's go to inflate and hover the mouse over the facets and let's drag it to the left. Now hover the mouse over the polygons and let's drag it to the right. And now let's go to expand and let's hover the mouse over the facets and let's drag it to the left to expand them down. Okay, so that's it. Now I hope you can create this on your own, and let's right click and shade it smooth. And that's it guys, I hope now you can create cool furnitures with our cloth modifier. So if you like this video, hit that like button and consider subscribing for more great content, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.